Suppose 505 divided by 72. 505 divided by 72. What is the quotient and what is the remainder? First divisor. What is the divisor? That is 72. You should write down tens digit in the base part and unit digit in the flag position. And then write down that dividend that is equal to 505. What is the next step? Just to cross check how many digits are there in the flag. Here only one digit. That's why we should divide this number after one digit from your right hand side. Up to here, any doubt? What is the next step? Okay, what is the next step? You should divide this 50 with 7. What is the quotient? 7. And what is the remainder? 1. You should write down remainder at before the 5. Now this number is read it as that is equal to 15. Okay, up to here, any doubt?
Can you explain again?
Here, 72 divisor, tens place is written in the bottom part, base part, and the unit digit written in the power part. This is called as flag. And what is the dividend? That is equal to 505. Now you should check how many digits are there in the flag position. That is equal to 1. You should break this number after one digit from your right hand side. Suppose in the flag, two digits are there. You should break this number after two digits from your right hand side and so on. Okay. Now what happened? 7 times 49. Okay. What is the remainder? Remainder is equal to 1. You should write down the remainder before this 5. Is it clear, Lassasri?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, what is the next step? It's very important. You should multiply the flag number and the quotient. What is the quotient? 7. What is the flag? That is equal to 2. 7, 2 times that is equal to 14. Now 15 minus 14, that is equal to 1. So 1 is remainder and 7 is quotient. That is answer. That's it. Is it clear? Once again, I'm going to explain. 505 divided by 72. In the divisor, tens place, tens position, that is that 7, and a flag as 2, 505. In the flag, only one digit. That's why you should break this number after one digit from your right hand side. Now, you should divide this 50 with 7, 7 times 49, and the remainder is equal to 1. What next? You should multiply the flag and the quotient. 7, 2 times that is equal to 14. 15 minus 14, that is equal to 1. 1 is a remainder and 7 is a quotient. That's it. Is it clear, all of you?
Yes, sir.
Suppose 503 divided by 72. Tell me, Nana.
Sir, what is your doubt? Use
what, Nana?
Sir, is this method used for all numbers?
All numbers. This is a universal method, okay? Now, 7, 2, 5, 0, 3. All of you listen carefully. You should break this number after one digit from your right hand side. Next, listen carefully, all of you. 7 times 49 and the remainder is equal to 1. Up to here, no doubt, no change. Now, 7, 2 times that is equal to 14. 13 minus 14 is equal to minus 1. 13 minus 14, that is equal to minus 1. Okay. Now, what is the remainder? Remainder is always positive or not? Remainder always positive. So suppose if you take 7, Suppose if you take 7 as a quotient, you will get that negative value. So what should you do? Already I explained yesterday. Here, let us consider, see, 10 divided with 3, 3, 3 times 9, and the remainder equal to 1. 10, 3, 3, 2 times 6, and the remainder equal to 4. 10, remainder 3, 1 times 3, and the remainder equal to 7, right? In the same way, 7, 6 times, that is equal to 42 on it. 7, 6 times, that is equal to 42, right? Suppose if you take 7, 7 times, and the remainder is equal to 1. Instead of that one, just you should take 7, 6 times. That is equal to 42. Then what is the remainder? If you divide this 50 with 7, 7, 6 times 42, and the remainder is equal to 8. Now you should write down 8 here. Is it clear, all of you? Suppose if you take 7 as a quotient, remainder is equal to 1. You will get that negative remainder. Suppose instead of 7, suppose if you take 7, 6, if you take 6, what is the remainder? That is equal to 8. Why? Because 7, 6 times 42 and the remainder is equal to 8. Now, same procedure. Here, 6, 2 times, that is equal to 12. 83 minus 12, that is equal to 71 is a remainder and 6 as a quotient. That's it. That is the difference. Once again, I'm going to explain this question. 503 divided by 72. Okay, 7 as a base, 2 as a flag, 503. You should break this number after one digit from your right hand side. Suppose if you take 7 times, remainder is equal to 1. Now you should multiply the flag and the quotient 7, 2 times, that is equal to 14. 13 minus 14 is equal to minus 1. Here, remainder always be positive, but here, negative. That's why instead of 7, just you should take 6. Then what happened? 7, 6 times 42, and the remainder is equal to 8. Now, 6, 2 times, that is equal to 12. 83 minus 12, that is equal to 71 is a remainder, and 6 as a question. Is it clear, all of you?
Yes, sir.
Okay, I'm going to explain one more example. Let us take 97 divided by 28. 97 divided by 28. 2, 8, 9, 7. What should you do? In this flag, only one digit. That's why you should break this number after one digit from your right hand side. Okay, now you should divide this 9 with 2. 2, 4 times 8, and the remainder is equal to 1. Now multiply the flag at this number, 8, 4 times, that is equal to 32. 17 minus 32, you will get a negative value. But all of us know that negative remainder always positive. So what should you do? Instead of 4, just you should take 3. 2, 3 times 6. What is the remainder? Remainder is equal to 3. Okay. Here 9 and a remainder 2. 2, 3 times 6 and the remainder is equal to 3. What is the next step? You should multiply the flag and fresh quotient. What is the flag here? That is 8. What is the fresh quotient? 3. 8, 3 times, that is equal to 24. Now, if you subtract 24 from 37, you have 13 as a remainder and 3 as a quotient. Is it clear, all of you?
Yes, sir.
I'm going to explain one more example. 184 divided by 47. 4 is a base and 7 as a flag. 1, 8, 7. You should break this number after one digit from your right hand side. Suppose if you take 4, 4 times. And what is the remainder? Remainder is equal to 2. But 7, 4 times is equal to 28. 27 minus 28, that is equal to minus 1. So it's not positive. Now, what should you do? Here, just instead of 4, you should take 3. 4, 3 times 12, and the remainder is equal to 6. What is the next step? Multiply the flag and quotient. This is equal to 21. 67 minus 21, that equals 46 as a remainder, and 3 as a quotient. Okay, but all these things are calculated in your mind only. Before you write down 4, just calculate. Suppose if you take 4 and here remainder equal to 2. 27 minus 28 is more than, you will get the negative value. That's why instead of 4, you should take 3. I'm going to explain one more example. Let us take 210 divided by 53. 5 as a base, 3 as a flag, 2, 1, 0. Break this number. Suppose if you take 5 4 times, remainder equal to 1. Here this is equal to 10, but here 4 is there. 4 3 times, 12. So 12 is more than 10. That's why what should you do? Instead of 4, you should take 3. 5 3 times 15, and the remainder is equal to 6. What is the next step? You should multiply this flag and quotient, that is equal to 9, 60 minus 9, 51 as a remainder, and 3 as a quotient. Is it clear, all of you?
Yes, sir.
Get it out. I think all of you, maximum, you did mistake the first one and sixth one. 6, 3, 3, 7, 3. Break this number after one digit from your right hand side. 6, 6 times, 36, and the remainder is equal to 1. 6, 3 times 18, you will get negative value. So, what should you do? Instead of 6, you should take 5. 5, 30, and 7. 5, 3 times, that is equal to 15. 73 minus 15, that equals 58 is the remainder, and a 5 as a quotient. Is it clear, Harshika?
Sir, I sent you the correct answer actually. I did the sixth one wrong.
Oh, okay, okay. Oh, any doubt? Remaining? Okay, now come to the sixth one. What is the sixth one? 3, 3, 3, 5, 9. Okay, now suppose 5, 6 times, 30, and the remainder equal to 3. But 6, 9 times, that got 54, right? So instead of that one, you should take 5 only. Suppose if you take 5, 5, 5 times 35, this is equal to 8. This is equal to 45. So 83 minus 45. What happened? I got 38 is a remainder, and a 5 as a quotient. Is it clear? Correct? 35. 45.
Right answer.
And it is 50, 38. Yeah, sorry. Okay. I thought it is 353. Okay, no issues. Is it clear, all of you?
Yes, sir.